Y'all get ready.
Yes, you get ready.
Shout out to all my tea sippers out there. We are gathered here today to sip some tea, honey. So make sure you guys have your teacups ready because you already know this tea is what? Piping hot. Hey, you guys. So I wanted to come on here and do a late night vlog. I just got back from the gym. And while I was working out, I was getting sent a bunch of messages about this whole conversation that went down today on The Real. So if you guys do not know, The Real, the women of The Real, they're kind of upset with bloggers and YouTubers and people who do commentary. They feel like a lot of people are not only lying in their commentary, making up stuff, claiming they have sources, and they don't. And Tamara feels like there should be consequences for that. She said when she goes onto YouTube, she sees a bunch of videos about her and her fellow, you know, castmates. And a lot of them are just filled with lies and, you know, it's not fair and it's not okay. I want you guys to go ahead and check out this clip and I'm going to come back with the rest of my commentary.
At Roc Nation tells us Jay-Z hasn't spoken to any sources.
That was hilarious.
Why are we so quick to believe sources?
Yeah. And why are we so quick to empower blogs and online news media that people start themselves without any credibility? So weird.
It's like if reputable media can't even give the facts properly, what makes you believe that, like, a random blog on Instagram is telling the truth?
Right.
Like, we watch and these major reputable news outlets and we're like, that's correct. And sometimes their facts are off. We're looking at it like, that is not correct.
Because people so want to talk. People are just naturally nosy. People want to talk. The thing is with this situation, with the Colin Kaepernick situation, is that, and I've said this before, I think I said this last week, we don't know all the details. Mm-hmm. We don't know everything. And sometimes we don't know the details for our good. Jay-Z has never really, when he did speak, he spoke while he was in a news conference and people didn't like it. So now that he's not speaking, people don't like it. And sometimes you just got to let things work itself out for a reason.
What a crazy idea.
What is it?
Shouldn't it somewhat be illegal to be a source without them saying who you are? I feel like if you feel bold enough to speak up about it, let your name be known. Yep. Say who you are. Who is source? That seems so cowardly.
Well, you can hit the
it's just cowardly.
You can hit the person that is reporting the source. Mm-hmm. Like if you feel like defamation of character or things like that, then you can go to the actual the media outlet.
How can we do that though? How can we do that? Because I feel like
you put a cease and desist.
I know, but I feel like I feel helpless, honestly. You go on YouTube, you see so many stories about each and every one of us. They're so far from the truth. But what really sucks is they've got like 1 million to 2 million views. And I feel like the more divisive, the more like devious it is,
evil,
right? The more views they get.
Yeah.
So how can these people who do this, how can they get some consequences?
Like
they need to be held responsible because they're ruining some people's lives out there.
Yeah.
And defamation
and
of character.
They don't remember we have families.
We have lives.
And we have situations that affect our future.
All right, so you guys just saw the clip of the ladies talking about the entire situation. So there's a lot of different parts and nuances to what they're saying. And I definitely see their point. You have a lot of people on this platform who have abused it, okay? They have abused the commentary section. They have abused the entire commentary genre altogether. While you do have a lot of really good creators on this platform who have integrity, who do research, who are honest, who don't clickbait, there's a new girl I just started watching. I don't know her name, but I'm loving her videos. She does a lot of videos on colorism and just, you know, really cool topics. Those type of channels are far and few between, okay? Then you have a crop of channels who they just don't give a damn. They'll just pull anything out the sky, pull it out their ass, and claim that they got it from this person or that person or a little birdie told them, and then they'll splash it out there as if it's real, you know? And you guys can say, well, this is just entertainment. It's no different than the National Enquirer. But again, if this was your life and somebody just said, oh, well, you're fucking such and such because I heard, and they spread it all over the office or all over the school, you'd be in your feelings, and especially if those same people are making money off of you. You know, it's one thing to spread a lie, but it's another thing when people are getting paid to perpetuate a lie and are doing anything for clicks and views. So I definitely understand these women for being upset, and it's not just them. Don't get it twisted. It's not just the women of the real. I know a lot of celebrities out here who feel the same exact way, you know, and I have conversations with a lot of celebrities, and they're like, you know, you're probably one of the few that actually has integrity, that does research. It's just not out here dragging just to be dragging or being just super disrespectful or talking about their kids and their family and things like that. I keep it about the topic, I keep it about the behavior, and I keep it moving. You know, there's a way to do things with integrity and with class, but of course, that's not as popular as people just making up stuff. So I definitely get their frustration, but I also have to look at this situation with my tin hat on, because you guys know I'm a slight conspiracy theorist, honey. I'm a big conspiracy theorist, damn it, and I'm gonna just be honest, okay? So if you guys do not know, which a lot of y'all don't know what goes on the back end of YouTube, but today the YouTube CEO, Susan Wojcicki, she sent out her quarterly letter, okay? And one of the main topics of the quarterly letter was addressing the whole creator-on-creator harassment policy. Now, this first came to light back in August, where she did a sit-down interview with a big-time YouTuber about, you know, creators harassing other creators, sending their fans after them, having people troll them, and, you know, taking, you know, their drama to Instagram and Twitter, and, you know, just really harassing people over bullshit, over lies, and everything else. So this came to light when Alfie Days did an hour-long interview with her, and they were talking about the harassment that Vox host Carlos Meza received from Steven Crowder. And so that was like a really big controversy. Then we seen the whole thing that went down with James Charles and Tati Westbrook and how her fans went after him and vice versa. But let's keep it real. There's only something being done now because it's white content creators being affected. I know black content creators such as myself who have been harassed. I've seen other black content creators get the same treatment, be doxxed, threatened, and everything else. And when people in the black sector were complaining, it was, oh, well, y'all deal with it. But then when the same shit happened to these big white YouTubers, now there needs to be a policy change. You see how that works? So anyways, they've been talking about this for a while. So this is where the conspiracy comes in. This letter just came out this morning. And isn't it funny that after this letter came out this morning about Susan Wojcicki, basically, you know, they didn't go into details on the new harassment policy, but from what I'm hearing, a lot of commentary channels are going to be affected. So this is just a snippet here. So basically, she's saying that the company is now in the process of developing a new harassment policy. They were talking to creators about what needed to be addressed. She didn't give an ETA of the rollout, but she stated that she would let creators know when everything was finalized. From what I've been hearing through the grapevine, they're going to make one of the policies be where other YouTubers cannot talk about other YouTubers, okay? So if you have an issue with this YouTuber or that YouTuber, you cannot talk about them. You will receive some type of punishment to your channel.
He's now in a process of developing new harassment policy. Great. Yeah. Eventually, we already know that you basically can't make videos about other creators. And given YouTube's, you know, obsession with being the new TV, we're not going to be able to roast public figures anymore because everybody's just a YouTuber now.
So what I find very funny is that the same day that she's letting everybody know that this is what's rolling out, there is going to be a creator and creator harassment policy, The Real decides to talk about basically being harassed by YouTubers and bloggers and everything else. So I found that very funny that that was the topic of the day right along with this rollout. What people need to realize is that, once again, if you guys have not watched my live stream about COPA, please go back and watch it. Old media is dying, okay? The Real and The View and all these other talk shows, they'd much rather just be on television. They don't necessarily want to come to YouTube and have their, you know, stuff on YouTube. That's the point of being a mainstream celebrity. That's the point of being a mainstream commentator. But like she said, us YouTubers, you know, we're getting hundreds and thousands, sometimes millions of views on videos. And that's competition for them. People don't care about necessarily what Tamara has to say about a topic, but for whatever reason, people do care what I have to say about a topic. That's not my fault, okay? It is what it is. And I think a lot of it, yes, there's jealousy. Like I said, I understand the blatant lying and the making up of shit. That's totally wrong. I would never co-sign that. But there's also a blatant jealousy. There's also a blatant animosity. Because again, like I stated in my live stream, YouTube and this social media platform has been able to make regular schmegler people millionaires, thousandaires, and been able to live comfortably, you know what I'm saying, doing their own thing. We didn't have to go to school to do commentary. We didn't have to kiss ass or suck anybody's peen for our big break in Hollywood. I didn't have to sleep on any director's couch.
Fuck your couch, nigga. Buy another one, you rich motherfucker. Fuck your couch, nigga.
I created my own platform by myself. I didn't need anybody's cosign. I didn't need to be buddy-buddy with anybody in particular. And this bothers a lot of mainstream people. They are upset that a lot of people on YouTube, people like The Shade Room, you know, Bossip, Media Takeout, they have a fan base. They have people who go to them for the news, who go to them to see what's going on, as opposed to people who are seasoned, who've taken, you know, teleprompter classes and acting classes. You know, what's the point of spending all this money to go through the Hollywood channels only to not be in competition with somebody who's never had to do any of that because they're a YouTuber? And at this point, a lot of these celebs are definitely feeling some type of way. I see it. I see the animosity. I see the jealousy. Like I said, I definitely agree with them for being upset about people lying about them. But when it comes down to it, it's also about money. We get views. People are making money off this platform. And the mainstream, the old media, is not liking that at all. So what's going to happen? Mark my words. Tigro Dama said it here first. When they roll out this creator on creator policy, they're going to make it where it's basically going to smother most of these commentary channels, okay? Especially the ones who don't have integrity. They're definitely going to be smothered because all they live off of is drama and bullshit and negativity. So what's going to happen is basically, if you guys have not noticed, literally every celeb now has a YouTube page. I mean, at this point, YouTube is suggesting, you know, celebrity pages I'm not subscribed to, I don't give a shit about. Jenny May has a YouTube page. Tamara has a YouTube page. Adrian Bylon. All of these celebrities have a YouTube page. And I feel that the reason why Hollywood is pushing all of these mainstream people to create YouTube channels is because of this new policy. The creator on creator harassment. Because now, if I'm an A-list celebrity and I create a YouTube page and I do some bullshit and YouTubers decide to call me out or talk about this situation or give commentary, well, now you can't. Why? Because I'm one of your peers. I'm no longer an A-list celebrity that you can do commentary about. I'm a YouTuber too. So that's where the conspiracy comes in. So I find it very funny and very, you know, I find it very funny and very coincidental that the same day Susan Wojcicki put out this newsletter that Tamara and the rest of the ladies on The Real are now crying about harassment and YouTubers not having sources and, you know, making up stuff about them and how it's not fair and what can they do about this. Well, what's going to happen is that that creator on creator harassment policy will be rolling out and then they'll be able to do something about people talking about them, you know, that they feel shouldn't be saying anything about them. But again, like I said, it's going to be very interesting to see where YouTube goes in 2020. If you're assuming that it's just going to be the family channels being affected and people who talk, you know, who make kids content being affected, you better wake up. They're coming for a lot of channels. And like I've been saying for years, if you don't have some type of side hustle or alternative income coming in, good luck. Because at this point, they're coming for a lot of people. A lot of the drama channels they're coming from. Because, again, you have some who have integrity and, you know, they spill tea and they talk about different drama, but they do it in a lighthearted, fun way. Then you have some who are just simply agents of chaos. They're miserable. They're struggle beauty channels that never made it. So now I'm just going to sit here and talk shit about every beauty guru who's doing something, who's made it mainstream, who's popular. I'm going to just, you know, pick on every little thing that they do because I too wanted to be a beauty guru, but because nobody gave a shit about my makeup techniques or didn't think I was pretty enough or funny enough or just whatever, didn't have enough personality, now I'm gonna make a drama channel, you know, bitching and whining and tearing other people down 24/7. So unfortunately, you have that sector on YouTube as well. So it's gonna be very interesting to see how all this plays out. But me personally, like I said on Instagram, I'm not offended in the least. These women have the right to their opinions just like I have the right to my opinions. And again, when you have integrity about everything that you do and you actually research and you don't put out fake stories and you don't go out there to go hurt people purposely or be rude and disrespectful, then you really shouldn't be upset. You know, at the end of the day, they have a platform. They're going to state their opinion just like I have a platform and I'm going to state my opinion. So anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this entire situation concerning the women of The Real. Definitely feeling some type of way about bloggers and YouTubers talking about them. And then do you guys find it coincidental know that Susan Wojcicki sent out that letter earlier today, and the Real just so happened to be talking about basically creator on creator, you know, harassment and drama and things like that, even though that's not what they called it. So let me know your thoughts on everything. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Make sure you hit the thumbs up button. And most importantly, don't forget to hit that notification bell so that we can be down with the notification squad. I'll talk to you guys later. Deuces.